Good morning. Please join me in praying the rosary to our Blessed Mother. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he arose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. For an increase in vocations. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. For an increase in faith. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. For an increase in love. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The first sorrowful mystery, the agony in the garden. Jesus came with them to Gethsemane, and sadness came over him and great distress. Then he said, "My soul is sorrowful to the point of death. Wait here and keep awake with me." Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us of our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Let us pause to meditate on the first sorrowful mystery, the agony in the garden. The second sorrowful mystery, the scourging at the pillar. Despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows, harshly dealt with, he bore it humbly, like a lamb that is led to the slaughterhouse. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us of our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Let us pause to meditate on the second sorrowful mystery, the scourging at the pillar.
So, this is one of the things that's on my list. How did Jerry use for the Mass instead of
the third sorrowful mystery, the crowning with thorns. The soldiers led him away to the praetorium. Then they stripped him and dressed him up in purple. And having twisted some thorns into a crown, they put this on his head and placed a reed in his right hand. To make fun of him, they knelt to him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews." Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us of our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Let us pause to meditate on the third sorrowful mystery, the crowning with thorns. The fourth sorrowful mystery, the carrying of the cross. If anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross every day and follow me. And carrying his own cross, they led him out to be crucified. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us of our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Let us pause to meditate on the fourth sorrowful mystery, the carrying of the cross. The fifth sorrowful mystery, the crucifixion. When they reached the place they called the skull, they crucified him. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them. They do not know what they are doing." Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us of our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Let us pause to meditate on the fifth sorrowful mystery, the crucifixion. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech thee, that by meditating on these mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain always with us, and may the souls of the faithfully departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. Good morning. We joyfully welcome all to our historic Cathedral Basilica. If you are visiting or a newcomer, kindly fill out our special welcome envelope found in your pew, and please place that in today's collection basket. God's holy word calls us to open our hearts that we might see the will of God. Our second collection today is for Catholic Relief Services. As we prepare for today's celebration, I invite you to fully participate in the music of today's liturgy by singing from our hymnal and its inserted green music sheet. During this flu season, I invite you to appropriately greet those seated around you and share your name with those you've never met. Please stand and join us in singing our opening penitential litany.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us kneel. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us stand. Let us pray. O God, who through your word reconcile the human race to yourself in a wondrous way. Grant, we pray, that with prompt devotion and eager faith, our elect and all the Christian people may hasten to scrutinize their sins and proceed toward the solemn celebrations of Holy Week to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. I invite our children in pre-K through third grade to kindly come forward. All of our children in pre-K through third grade. And let us turn to our blessing over our children, which is found inside the back cover of our maroon worship aid. All of our children in pre-K through third grade. Let us extend our hands of blessing over our children. Lord our God, out of the speech of little children you have fashioned a hymn of praise. Look with kindness on our children as they go forth to hear and reflect upon your holy word. We pray that you, God of love, will also send your blessing upon them so that they may grow in Christian maturity and by the power of the Holy Spirit become Christ's witnesses in the world, living and spreading our faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, we'll see in a little bit. And you can walk down with them. Mom, you can walk down with them.
Let the children come to me.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. The Lord said to Samuel, "Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I am sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem, for I have chosen my king from among his sons." As Jesse and his sons came to the sacrifice, Samuel looked at Eliab and thought, "Surely the Lord's anointed is here before him." But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not judge from his appearance or from his lofty stature, because I have rejected him. Not as man sees does God see, because man sees the appearance, but the Lord looks into the heart." In the same way, Jesse presented seven sons before Samuel. But Samuel said to Jesse, "The Lord has not chosen any one of these." Then Samuel asked Jesse, "Are these all the sons you have?" Jesse replied, "There is still the youngest who is tending the sheep." Samuel said to Jesse, "Send for him. We will not begin the sacrificial banquet until he arrives here." Jesse sent and had the young man brought to them. He was ruddy, a youth handsome to behold, and making a splendid appearance. The Lord said, "There, anoint him, for this is the one. Then Samuel, with the horn of oil in hand, anointed David in the presence of his brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon David. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of light, for light produces every kind of goodness and righteousness and truth. Try to learn what is pleasing to the Lord. Take no part in the fruitless works of darkness. Rather, expose them. For it is shameful even to mention the things done by them in secret. But everything exposed by the light becomes visible. For everything that becomes visible is light. Therefore, it says, "Awake, O sleeper, and arise from the dead, and Christ will give you light." The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to John. As Jesus passed by, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, "Neither he nor his parents sinned. It is so that the works of God might be made visible through him. We have to do the works of the one who sent me while it is day. Night is coming when no one can work. While I am in the world, I am the light of the world." When he had said this, he spat on the ground and made clay with saliva, and smeared the clay on his eyes and said to him, "Go wash in the pool of Siloam," which means sent. So he went and washed and came back able to see. His neighbors and those who had seen him earlier as a beggar said, "Isn't this the one who used to sit and beg?" Some said, "It is." But others said, "No, he just looks like him." He said, "I am." So they said to him, "How were your eyes opened?" He replied, "The man called Jesus made clay and anointed my eyes and told me, 'Go to Siloam and wash.' So I went there and washed and was able to see." And they said to him, "Where is he?" He said, "I don't know."
He hid the darkness of my mind the day he gave my sight to me. It was not sin that made me blind. It was no sin.
Brought the one who was once blind to the Pharisees. Now Jesus had made clay and opened his eyes on the Sabbath. So then the Pharisees also asked him how he was able to see. He said to them, "He put clay on my eyes, and I washed, and now I can see." So some of the Pharisees said, "This man is not from God, because he does not keep the Sabbath." But others said, "How can a sinful man do such things?" And there was a division among them. So they said to the blind man again, "What do you have to say about him, since he opened your eyes?" He said, "He is a prophet." Now the Jews did not believe that he had been blind and gained his sight, until they summoned the parents of the one who had gained his sight. They asked them, "Is this your son, who you say was born blind? How does he now see?" The parents answered and said, "We know that this is our son, that he was born blind. We do not know how he sees now, nor do we know who opened his eyes. Ask him. He is of age. He can speak for himself." His parents said this because they were afraid of the Jews, for the Jews had already agreed that if anyone acknowledged him as the Christ, he would be expelled from the synagogue. For this reason, his parents said, "He is of age. Question him." So a second time they called the man who had been blind and said to him, "Give God the praise. We know this man is a sinner." He replied, "If he is a sinner, I do not know. One thing I do know is that I was blind, and now I see." So they said to him, "What did he do to you? How did he open your eyes?" He answered them, "I told you already, and you did not listen. Why do you want to hear it again? Do you want to become his disciples too?"
He healed the darkness of my mind, the day he gave my sight to me. It was not sin that made me blind, it was no sinner made me see.
They ridiculed him and said, "You are the man's disciples. We are disciples of Moses. We know that God spoke to Moses, but we do not know where this one is from." The man answered and said to them, "This is what is so amazing, that you do not know where he is from, yet he opened my eyes. We know that God does not listen to sinners, but if one is devout and does his will, he listens to him. It is unheard of that anyone ever opened the eyes of a person born blind. If this man were not from God, he would not be able to do anything." They answered and said to him, "You were born totally in sin, and you are trying to teach us?" Then they threw him out. When Jesus heard that they had thrown him out, he found him and said, "Do you believe in the Son of Man?" He answered and said, "Who is he, sir, that I may believe in him?" Jesus said to him, "You have seen him. The one speaking with you is he." He said, "I do believe, Lord," and he worshiped him. Then Jesus said, "I came into this world for judgment, so that those who do not see might see, and those who do see might become blind." Some of the Pharisees who were with him heard this and said to him, "Surely we are not also blind are we? Jesus said to them, if you were blind, you would have no sin. But you are saying, we see, so your sin remains.
He healed the darkness of my mind the day he gave my sight to me. It was not sin that made me blind. It was no sinner made me see.
The Gospel of the Lord.
We welcome all to our historic Cathedral Basilica on this fourth Sunday of Lent. And we wear rose-colored vestments to celebrate what we call Laetare Sunday, which is a Sunday in which we know that the Passion is coming closer and closer to us in just a few weeks. We will be celebrating the Passion Sunday, or Palm Sunday. In a particular way, we welcome all those who are visiting with us from other places, other parishes, other cities, other communities, and even other countries. And we assure you of our Lenten prayers for you in a very special way, and also we are joyful that you are here with us to celebrate Mass. At the end of the Mass, there'll be a special blessing for all of our visitors and all those who'll be traveling during the coming week, that you might travel in safety. And for our visitors on the plaza, there is a visitor stand or a welcome stand, and we ask you as visitors just to stop there and pick up a gift that we have there for you that you can take home and deepen your faith, deepen the faith of those who reside with you, and also deepen the faith of those who come to visit with you. In the bulletin today and in our East Texas Catholic and also on the Diocesan website, and also going to be on our website, is a special letter from the bishop. It's called the pastoral letter. And a pastoral letter from a bishop is a usually major undertaking for a major reason. And our bishop issues this pastoral letter called Looking Back in Thanksgiving and Looking Forward in Hope. It's written to the faithful and the religious and all the clergy of the Diocese of Beaumont. The letter, which is in the bulletin, it's 5 pages long, so I'm not going to read it. But it's an easy read. It's an easy read, and I encourage you to read it and also discuss it in your family. Offers us a context of our diocese's development since its establishment 50 years ago. And within that context, the bishop focuses our attention on the current and long-term shortages of priests. For sacramental, especially the Eucharist, and pastoral care in our parishes and missions, we are coming to a critical point in the diocese for the need of priests. In the pastoral letter, the facts and data are made available for your consideration and for your prayer. The bishop presents challenges for all of us to understand and asks us to have patience and indispensable collaboration as we, the Catholic Christian community in Southeast Texas, adjust to the reality of the declining number of priests and the immediate impact this fact is having on the pastoral ministry of the church. I'll just read to you from the third page for our statistics for 2017. We have 23 diocesan priests who are pastors of parishes. We have 54 parishes and a number of mission stations. These pastors, diocesan pastors, range from the age of 42 to 83. Four of these pastors are above the normal age of retirement, 70. So we have, we certainly have one pastor right at St. Anne's, and most of us know him. He's 83 years old, and he's running St. Anne's Parish, which has a school. It's a large parish, very active parish, but he's 83 years old. Four of these pastors are almost 70, and I'm one of them. And that's retirement age from administration, okay? But most priests will stay on some years after their right by canon law and right by particular law to retire from administration. They stay on longer until their health starts giving out. These 23 pastors cover 26 parishes and three missions. And three of these pastors covers two parishes. So there's three out of the 23 that cover two parishes. There is one diocesan priest who covers two parishes and two missions. And he runs around like a chicken without a head, trying to celebrate masses. We only have three associate pastors to assist in our three largest parishes. And one of our largest parishes does not have an assistant priest. That's St. Jude's. It only has, is the second largest in the diocese, only has one priest, the pastor. It has Father Jack, who lives within our parish and was with us helping out here. He wanted to be home after his retirement at 77, taking care of, I believe, 7,000 households in his parish and just could not handle it anymore. So the cardinal asked him to retire. Currently, we only have five seminarians. One of them comes from our parish. Now, for the religious order, we have 17 religious order priests that are pastors. Father George and Father Joe, who's with us this morning, are not pastors of the parishes. They cover all the nursing homes throughout the diocese. That's to take the stress off pastors. So all the nursing homes are covered. They also, on the weekend, usually are out in a parish where a pastor is sick, or a pastor is away, and they are filling in that parish. These 17 pastors cover 18 parishes, 4 missions, and 1 mission station. So you can see that they are running around quite a bit. They run in age from 42 to 95. So the pastor at Cristo Rey, who takes care of Cristo Rey, which is just a half mile away, is 95 years old. And he's still running a parish. So we see that just with regard to priests, there is really a crisis coming up. And it's already present. Because what happens when somebody craters with health? What happens when one of them dies with their boots on and is in a large parish? And there's no one to take his place. And so the pastoral letter is very, very important to give you an understanding of, as we look back, how blessed we have been. As we look forward, how many challenges we have for the future. The Holy Father did in an interview just not too long ago in Germany, for a German newspaper, and mentioned even the fact of having married priests. We already do have priests who were Episcopal priests, or they were Lutherans. They converted after being ministers in those denominations, and then they took on theological study, and then were ordained a Roman Catholic priest. They have families. They have wives. And of course, our deacons, we have 9 deacons coming up, and 2 of those deacons come from our parish. So our parish is producing vocations. We have 1 seminarian and 2 deacon candidates. But we need your prayers. So become aware of, please, the Catholic Church's need for vocations in Southeast Texas. Priests do not fall out of the sky. They are nurtured in families. They are nurtured in families. And if the priests do not rise out of the children in families who have good Catholic formation, we won't have any priests in the future. And there will have to be things done that are really going to be a new paradigm shift for the Catholic Church. So I encourage you to read, the bishop encourages to read, and to ponder and pray over the pastoral letter that is in today's bulletin. Looking back in thanksgiving, looking forward in hope.
Monsignor Jerry, my brothers and sisters in baptism of our Cathedral Basilica community, our elect Alexis Wilkes continues to journey with us during this season of repentance for our 2nd week of scrutinizing her life, in which she will reject sin and be blessed with a deeper spirit of repentance in preparation for the celebration of the Easter sacraments.
Alexis, my dear elect of God, kindly come out into the middle of our main aisle and pray with us as we pray with you, that Christ may open the eyes of your heart with his divine light to reject every false value of Satan that spiritually blinds you and also spiritually blinds us. May he dispel the darkness of evil as you examine your life, and as we also examine our lives, we who are already baptized, may we all reject sin and be blessed with a deeper spirit of repentance in preparation for the celebration of the Easter sacraments. My dear brothers and sisters in baptism, as we journey together toward Easter, let us stand and pray for our elect and our universal church, that all of us who believe in Christ might examine our lives, be given a greater spirit of repentance, more profound sense of sin, and the true freedom of the children of God.
For the peace of our world, especially in the Middle East and Holy Land, for the unity of all Christians and God's people. Commitment in living the Eucharist, for members of our Catholic family who have been away from the sacraments, for all elect who scrutinize the sins they have committed, for the defense of human life and religious liberty, for struggling marriages and families, the sick, suffering, poor, powerless, elderly, homeless, and unemployed. Oh Lord, hear my prayer. Oh Lord, hear my prayer. When I call, answer me. Oh Lord, hear my prayer. Oh Lord, hear my prayer. For the success of our bishop's faith appeal, for vocations to the priesthood, permanent diaconate, religious life, and service of the church, for our beloved dead and all who grieve, especially Lawrence Payne Sr., and for our troops, travelers, visitors, and our silent intentions.
Father of mercies, you led the man born blind to the kingdom of light through the gift of faith in your Son, Jesus Christ. Free this elect from the false values that surround and bind her. Set her firmly in your truth as a daughter of light forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
My dear elect, I now anoint you with the oil of catechumens, the oil of salvation, in the name of Christ our Savior. May he strengthen you by the power of his Son and save you from your sins. And we ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Spirit, one God forever and ever. My sisters and brothers in baptism, let us extend our hands over our elect. Lord Jesus, you are the true light that enlightens the world. Through your Spirit of truth, free your elect, who is enslaved by the father of lies. Stir up the desire for good in your elect. Let your elect rejoice in your light, that she might see like the one born blind. May she be strong and fearless witness of the faith, for you are Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
My dear elect and candidates preparing for the Easter sacraments, take your leave now to more deeply reflect upon God's holy word, to scrutinize your life, to prepare for your baptism, to be in constant conversion from sin to new life in Christ. And until we meet again, be assured of our prayers, and that we long to celebrate the Eucharist with you at the celebration of Easter. Now take your leave from us.
Children to bring their gifts for Jesus and place them in the basket at the foot of the altar.
pray, my sisters and my brothers, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. We place before you with joy these offerings, which bring eternal remedy, O Lord. Bring that we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as is fitting for the salvation of our elect candidates and all the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Let us lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. By the mystery of the Incarnation, he has led the human race that walked in darkness into the radiance of faith and has brought those born in slavery to ancient sin through the waters of regeneration to make them your adopted children of the light. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing the new song of adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out and without end acclaim. Therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sin, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, who for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, and confessing your mercy, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed upon us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with your very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another.
May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people, and may he keep us in communion with Francis our Pope and Curtis our Bishop and all the bishops and your entire people.
Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, her all good and chaste spouse Joseph, the blessed apostles Peter and Paul, the martyrs, Saint Anthony, and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters, especially Lawrence and all those who have died, those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship, bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit. Let us offer to each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We believe that the most blessed sacrament of the altar is the true and full presence of Jesus Christ, his body, blood, soul, and divinity. As Catholics who are in the state of grace come to Holy Communion, those of other faiths are also invited to approach the altar with hands over their hearts and pray with the priests for the unity of all God's people.
Please join us in singing hymn number 614.
Let us pray. Lord, who enlighten everyone who comes into the world, illuminate our hearts, we pray, with the splendor of your grace, that we may always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty and love you in all sincerity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Faith formation students are to report to their class as usual this Wednesday at 5:45 p.m. Lenten Stations of the Cross are prayed every Friday at 6 p.m. Please bring your family to join in this sacred tradition. All are invited to join us here in our Cathedral Basilica at 3 p.m. this Sunday afternoon for our Lenten Meditation Choral and Instrumental Sacred Music Concert. We are in the process of producing a parish pictorial directory. Photo taking will begin the first week in May. Parishioners are urged to sign up after Mass today or next weekend to schedule your individual or family photo appointment. You are invited to attend a palm weaving workshop next Sunday in our chapter room after our 10 o'clock Mass. Come learn how to weave palm branches into crosses and other works of art. Before leaving, kindly tidy up your pew for our next Mass. Thank you.
This Thursday we'll begin our Ladies' Acts retreat, and on the table by the Easter candle is the sign up for the prayer during next weekend supporting the Acts retreat. So we ask you to sign up for 1 hour of prayer. Starting Thursday, going through Sunday, for our ladies who will be taking the Acts retreat, so that they're supported by our prayers. Mm-hmm. And I look forward to being with you this afternoon at 3 o'clock, when we will have a wonderful Lenten meditative concert and choral music and instrumental music, and that is here. And our sign-up table for the pictorial directory is on the plaza. I invite all those who are visiting with us and all those who are traveling to kindly stand and receive a special blessing. All of our visitors and all those who will be traveling. Let's ask God's blessing upon them. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he let his face shine upon you, be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with kindness and grant you safety in your journey. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And through the prayers of the Holy Mother of God, together with all the saints, especially our patron, Saint Anthony, may the Lord bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying God by your life.
Thanks be to God. Have a beautiful day. Look forward to being with you at 3 o'clock this afternoon. And remember this always. The Holy Spirit is in charge of the church, and he will not let the church falter. Remember that. We've gone through plenty of trials in our life as a church.